More MotoGP than ever, and more to come in 2024. An incredible season that began all the way back in March in Portimao has taken us to all corners of the globe. A marathon stretch of flyaways across the Asia-Pacific region before it all culminated here. The Ricardo Tormo circuit under the setting sun in Valencia. And this is now our opportunity to congratulate our champions in 2023. Here you see two riders who were once teammates in 2021, a year where Pedro Acosta emerged as the Moto3 champion. This year, he took the Moto2 prize overall in what was a stunning season for the rising young star of motorcycle racing. 19-year-old Pedro Acosta. A Moto2 campaign which certainly kept us guessing in the first half of the season. Some early mistakes from Pedro Acosta, which certainly allowed Tony Arbolino to steal an early march in the chase for the title. Arbolino taking victories in the very early stages of the season. One, of course, in the wet in Argentina, for taking advantage of a crash for Pedro Acosta at Le Mans to open up a 25-point World Championship lead at the French Grand Prix. Memorably, of course, our 1,000th Grand Prix weekend. But from that point on, that was the motorcycle with that stunning young talent on top of it, Pedro Acosta, which wrestled control of the Moto2 World Championship. Pedro Acosta's form in the middle of the season really saw him take it by the scruff of the neck. Back-to-back victories in Mugello and Sachsenring, which were the ideal way to respond to that crash at the French Grand Prix. Put in a run of five consecutive podium finishes for a slightly off weekend by his standards in Barcelona. For another run of three victories in four in Misano, India and Indonesia, ultimately put Pedro Acosta in the position of clinching the World Championship in Malaysia. And watch out MotoGP in 2024, because there's no question that Pedro Acosta is going to be a serious threat over the years. As for Jaume Massia on board that Leopard Honda, of course, it's been quite the road to the world title for the 23-year-old Spaniard. Jaume Massia in his second stint, of course, with the Leopard Honda team. Left them at the end of 2020 to go to Red Bull KTM IO, where he was teammates with the young man he's chatting to there, Pedro Acosta. Massia returning to the Leopard squad and handing Leopard yet another Moto3 riders title. What a record they have in the lightweight class. Champions with Danny Kent in 2015, Juan Mir in 2017, Lorenzo Dalla Porta in 2019. And in 2023, it's the name of Jaume Massia, which sits atop the Moto3 World Championship at the end of a season which has produced some spectacular action in the Moto3 class. Any one of at least half a dozen races could have made it into any race of the season conversation. For Jaume Massia, his title-winning campaign, well, it began with fifth place in Portimao before he crashed out of a podium position in the wet of Argentina. But in general, it has been a consistent campaign for the number five, although it's a number one, of course, you can now see on his Leopard Honda. Three podiums on the spin from Austin through to Le Mans. Certainly brought him back into the picture behind early championship leader Danny Holgado. First victory of the season, had to wait until the end of June at Assen. That last chicane move on Ayumu Sasaki, who would prove to be Massia's chief title rival by the time he arrived at the back end of the season. It appeared as if Massia's title hopes might well have faded with those back-to-back non-scores at Silverstone when he crashed out of the lead, and Austria when he hit mechanical problems. But it was what came next that really put Massia in the position to clinch the world championship this year. He took 90 points from a possible 100 in the next four races. Back-to-back seconds in Barcelona and Misano before consecutive wins from pole position in the back-to-back of India and Japan before the controversial, in some eyes, victory last time out in Qatar, which saw Jaume Massia clinch the Moto3 World Championship with a race to spare over Yumi Sasaki, who signed off with victory this afternoon to secure second place in the World Championship. And what can we say about this, man? Your 2023 MotoGP World Champion, Pecco Bagnaia, at the end of a season which saw more MotoGP than ever. The introduction of the new Tissot Sprint. And it felt rather fitting in some ways, didn't it, that the very first Tissot Sprint of the season and the last Grand Prix of the season were both won by Pecco Bagnaia. Didn't make life easy for himself in some of the earlier races. Crashed out of a likely second place in Argentina in the wet. Crashed out of what should have been a victory in Austin. But whenever Pecco Bagnaia has encountered problems, boy, has he bounced back. Victory at the Italian Grand Prix on home soil. Celebrated with a hot dog afterwards. And although Jorge Martin got the better of him at the Saxon Ring, Bagnaia struck back again at Assen to wrestle control of the World Championship. And it appeared when he took the sprint and race win double in Austria that Bagnaia had the title very much under control. But the lap one spill at the Catalan Grand Prix certainly saw him ride through pain in the races that followed. And Jorge Martin went on a tear, taking the double in Misano, the double again in Motegi, the double in Thailand as well, which set up this thrilling shootout for the crown this weekend in Valencia. Martin cutting the gap to 14 points with his victory in the Tissot Sprint yesterday. Bagnaia came into today's Valencia Grand Prix knowing that a fifth place was enough. And after some extraordinary action in the early stages of today's race, with Jorge Martin running off after almost making contact and taking Bagnaia out at the start of lap three, and then a crash whilst trying to recover back through the field when he collided with Marc Marquez, took Jorge Martin out of play, and in a thrilling finish to the final race of the season. It got the fitting finale in the end. Pecco Bagnaia holding off Fabio Di Gianantonio and Joan Zarco to take his seventh win of 2023. And with it, the World Championship. Back to Bagnaia is the hashtag that will be doing the rounds. El Tiburon for Pedro Acosta. And hashtag Massia with the number one replacing the I for our Moto3 World Champion. The world's media taking the photos, which will be on social media this afternoon. We'll be all over the internet this evening. We'll be in your Monday morning newspapers. These are your world champions in 2023. A season that will live long in the memory. We've seen spectacular action across all three classes. And ultimately, the excellence of the three gentlemen in front of you. We leave you in 2023 with our world champions, of course. Make sure you're with us on Tuesday as we start our look ahead to 2024 with the eagerly anticipated Valencia test. Marc Marquez set to make his debut on the Grassini Ducati. Alex Rins to make his debut on the Yamaha. Frankie Morbidelli switching across to a Pramac Ducati. Pedro Acosta here on screen will be making his MotoGP debut for the Gas Gas Factory Racing Tech 3 team. Our thank you to all of you that have watched this 2023 season and have made it so special, our thanks to everybody behind the scenes in this paddock and back at base in Barcelona from Dorna Sports to help put this incredible show on the road. It is the greatest spectacle in motorsport. And those are the riders that can call themselves world champions at the end of 2023. Jaume Massia, Pedro Acosta, and the MotoGP world champion, Pecco Bagnaia. We'll be right back.